Helium leaks and thruster issues put a strain on Boeing's Starliner crewed test flight mission following yesterday's launch.
Starliner missed its first window to dock today with the International Space Station. West 2 Stuart Moore joins us in studio right now to explain what these issues now mean for the mission. Stu?
Well, guys, the two American astronauts, Commander Butch Wilmore and pilot Sonny Williams, are now safe aboard the International Space Station and were not in any type of grave danger. The Starliner docked with the ISS at 1:34 this afternoon. But as we heard from officials today, the certification process of Starliner takes on even more importance.
Butch and Sonny have made their arrival.
Starliner, now docked to the International Space Station.
Welcome aboard, Starliner.
Butch and Sonny, nicely done. Welcome back to the ISS.
Outstanding. Great place to be. We're looking forward to staying here for a couple of weeks and getting all the things done in Starliner that we need to get done.
Excitement as Williams and Wilmore enter the ISS, a major step complete for their crew flight test mission.
We're just happy as can be to be up in space, one in Starliner, on an Atlas V, and then here on the International Space Station. It just doesn't get much better.
However, the trip up the hill did have a few bumps. Starliner reporting problems with reaction control thrusters. Those thrusters are used to steer the spaceship.
At different points, had five of those thrusters go offline, and through several hot fire tests, we were able to bring back four of those thrusters and obtain the go.
The thruster issues are in addition to three separate helium leaks. Helium not toxic to humans. Now the crew will stay on board for a week, and then the teams will choose a time for the undocking process.
And we are monitoring a NASA news conference happening right now. We'll have an update for you later on. Administrator Bill Nelson is expected to speak. Guys, back over to you.